us in our section 10 questions with. Together we have with us Maja Ban from Megayacht Services in Croatia. Maja, good afternoon. How are you doing?
Good afternoon, Alex. I'm very well, thank you. What about yourself?
All good here in this end of the world.
Yes.
Good to see you again.
Same here, Alex, and thank you very much for inviting me to be participating in your great project. It's my pleasure to be here with you.
Thank you, Maja. So, first question, who is Maja Ban?
Well, thank you for such a heavy question. If I can say in short, let's say Maja Ban is a Croatian, born and raised in Croatia, living in Croatia, but with an international family, married to American, raising two bilingual children in Croatia, and running for the last 13 years her own yacht service agency in Croatia.
Excellent. Maja, how did you start in the yachting sector?
Well, back in 2001, through a family member, I met a captain who was a yacht captain in Croatia, who mentioned how in Croatia there is a lack of yachting services. And that kind of intrigued me, and we started speaking more about it. We managed to spend some extra time due to him looking for the property in Croatia for the current owner. And he gave me advice, if you ever decide to start something like that, like your own business in yachting, it would be great that you go work on a yacht. And that's how I discovered the yachting. And in 2005, I became crew member. The rest is pretty much the history till this day.
Excellent. And Maja, tell me, how was that that you stepped forward from getting involved in the industry to create your own company, MYS?
Well, the whole idea of actually getting in the industry is around the idea to open one day my own business. I was working at the time in my family business, so I always had this drive inside to have something on my own. And yachting industry sounded and seemed something really exciting for me at the time in Croatia, because it would give me the opportunity to work internationally and to actually do what I really do love, and that's provide services.
Looking back in time, what would you change from your past experience?
If I would have to change something, I would probably start earlier working on the yachts and travel the world, because this is a great asset that crew working on the yachts does get, in my opinion.
Excellent. What three things would you take with you to a desert island?
Well, definitely a sunscreen, a lot of sunscreen. I would definitely do books, a lot of good, well, book, I guess, considering it's a three things only. And would it be wrong to say my children?
You're free to choose.
So that would be definitely it then. I would say lots of sunscreen, book, children. If I replace my children, that would be a pina colada.
Well done. All right, let's move forward. How do you see the future of the yachting industry in Croatia?
Well, as a relatively new yachting industry, when I say yachting, I mean mega yachts primarily. Definitely, there is a bright future, I believe, because as a popular destination, we do see the growth, if we put pandemic aside. Even during these times, Croatia, compared to some, unfortunately, other destinations, had a pretty good season last year. Definitely, we are ready as a country. We have the coastline, we have a natural beauties, but we definitely see also improvement on the infrastructure side.
Good. So, changing topic a little bit, Do you think women have enough representation in the industry?
Well, again, it's a pretty complex question. If I refer to statistics that were recently published in some reports that I've been reading, like from one of the greatest initiatives latest time as She of the Sea, definitely not. Women in general in yachting industry are still, like in every other, I would say, industry, not in a in majority when comes to, or equality in numbers when comes to a top positions, the top management positions. Statistically looking, among 30,000 crew, only 28% roughly are women, where 71% are men. So in that respect, initiatives like I mentioned, She for Sea, a Women Yachting Association as well, are something that I'm looking as a positive and bright side of yachting that is going to bring the awareness about the need of more women in a higher position.
Can you tell me what you think Croatia should envy from the rest of the world as a tourist destination?
Let's say a season, tourist season all year round. We still don't have that in Croatia.
Okay. And what do you think the rest of the world should envy from Croatia?
I would say definitely Croatia is one of the safest countries in the world. So safety and definitely clean nature, water and air.
Excellent. So last question, Maja, of our interview. How do you see yourself in 10 years time? Tell us.
Well, professionally, definitely overseeing day-to-day operations of MYS and working on some project that I already start thinking about. And above all, healthy and happy.
Excellent. I really appreciate you to take the time to share with us. And there's nothing else I can say on my end. Thank you for your time. And I hope the audience will like this interview, which I personally, I think it's been really, really fascinating. Thanks and see you soon.
Thank you, Alex, as well. It was a great pleasure and I really look forward to many more interviews with your some other very interesting participants. So thank you very much for the opportunity and I do hope we see each other in person very, very soon.
All right, Maja. And for all of you that you are checking and visiting our interviews and videos that we regularly publish, thanks again for your attention and hope to see you soon. Thank you.